Hey everyone, welcome back to another lecture that is of present continuous tense. Before dive into the definition, let's see the meanings of the words individually. Present. Present means now. Continuous. It means an action that is continued or ongoing action. Tense. Tense gives the concept of time. Now let's see the definition. Present continuous tense expresses the ongoing action occurring at the time of speaking. It is also known as present progressive tense, and its helping verbs are is, am, are. Okay, so it's pretty clear that this tense is used to show an action that is going on at the time of speaking or at the present time. Here is the structure of present continuous tense. In affirmative sentence, an affirmative sentence is also known as positive sentence. Subject plus helping verb. Helping verbs are is, am, are plus main verb, and main verb contain verb's first form plus ing form plus object. Now I'm going to tell you where to use these helping verbs. Is used with the subject, which is in third person singular, he, she, it, or any singular noun. Am, A-M-M. Am is used with a subject, that is, in first person singular, I. Are is used with a subject, that is, in first person plural, second person singular and plural, and third person plural. We, you, they are plural nouns. After understanding the structure of present continuous tense, here are the examples. I am teaching English. Here I is a subject, and with I we always use am as a helping verb. And here the main verb is teaching, and this teaching shows continuity in an action. And here English is an object. I am teaching English. And the second one is, she is eating the meal. With she, we always use is as a helping verb. The third one is, they are drawing a picture. They is a plural subject, and with they, we always use are as a helping verb. Here is the structure of negative sentence of present continuous tense. The structure will be the same. Here we're just going to add not after helping verb. Subject plus helping verb is MR plus not. Here not is used to show negation because we are going to make negative sentence, plus verb ing form plus object. And the examples are, I am not teaching English. She is not eating the meal. They are not drawing a picture. You see, to make these sentences negative, we just add not. Okay, so here is the structure of interrogative sentences of present continuous tense. In this structure, we make two changes, only two changes. The first is, we change the place of helping verbs, and the second one is, we add question mark at the end of the sentence. Because in interrogative sentence, we make questions, and to make questions, question mark is very important. Okay, so let's make interrogative sentence by keeping this structure in mind. Am I teaching English? Is she eating the meal? Are they drawing a picture? In all these sentences, helping verb comes at the beginning of the sentence and question mark at the end of a sentence. These two points are indication of interrogative sentence. Next, we are going to make negative interrogative sentences together. The structure of interrogative sentences will be the same. We're just going to add not to make it negative sentence. Then it becomes negative plus interrogative sentence. Let's see the structure. Helping verb comes first, is, am, are, because it is interrogative sentence, plus subject, plus not, because it is also a negative sentence, plus verb first form, ing, plus object. The examples are, am I not teaching English? Is she not eating the meal? Are they not drawing a picture? Okay, so now you are finally ready to make present continuous tense in every sentence type you want, isn't it? So give it a try at home. Thank you so much.